Hello everyone, today we discuss about unit 2, method of solution of differential equation of first order and first degree. In this unit, we discuss method of solution of differential equation of first order and first degree, separation of variable, reduced to variable separable from homogeneous differential equation and reduced to homogeneous differential equation. Variable separable form. So here consider the given differential equation in that form m dx plus n dy, where m and n are function of x and y respectively. So what is the solution procedure for solving a differential equation by separating variable separable form? So first step, we separate the variables. Suppose the given differential equation m dx plus n dy equal to 0, so we separate the variables. One side fx dx equal to gy dy. So here fx is only function of x and gy is only function of y. So this type of form is called the variable separable form. Next step, integrating both sides, equation number 2, and we get integration fx dx equal to integration gy dy plus c. And after solving this integration, we get the required solution of the differential equation. Problem. We have a problem. Solve the following differential equation. Dy upon dx equal to e to power x minus y plus x into e to power minus y. So suppose this is the given differential equation and we have write this differential equation. We take common e to power minus y right hand side and we get e to power minus y into e to power x. Dy upon dx equal to e to power minus y into e to power x plus x. So separating the variables, we get e to power y dy equal to e to power x plus x into dx. So this is the separating the variables form of the given differential equation. Dy into function of y and dx into function of x. Now integrating both sides and we get integration e to power y dy equal to integration e to power x plus x into dx plus c. And after solving this integration e to power y, integration e to power y and e to power x, integration e to power x and x, integration x square by 2 plus c. So this is the required solution of the given differential equation. These are some unsolved problems for practice. Now, if the given differential equation is not make the variable separable form, so then we reduce the given differential equation in variable separable form. Suppose such type of differential equation is that form dy upon dx equal to function of ax plus by plus c. So how to reduce the given differential equation in reducible to variable separable form? So first step, we put like that function ax plus by plus c equal to v. And differentiating two, we get ax. Differentiation x1, so a plus b into y, differentiation dy upon dx, and c differentiation 0, and v is also function of x, dv upon dx. So here we find the value of dy upon dx equal to 1 upon b into dv upon dx minus a. And putting this value dy upon dx and ax plus by plus c equal to v in the given function, given differential equation, and we get a function dv upon dx minus a equal to b into fv and dv upon dx equal to a plus b fv. And now we separating the variables dv upon a plus b into fv equal to dx. So this is the variable separable form. Now after getting the variable separable form, we integrating both side and we get the required solution of the given differential equation. So let's have a problem. Suppose dy upon dx equal to x plus y plus 3 square. Suppose this is the given differential equation and here we cannot separate in the variables. So we put x plus y plus 3 equal to v. So v differentiating this with respect to x and we get x 1 y dy upon dx 3 0 and v dv upon dx. So here we find the value of dy upon dx equal to dv upon dx minus 1. So putting the value of x plus y plus 3 equal to v and dy upon dx in equation number 1. So from 1 we get dv upon dx minus 1 in place of dy upon dx. and equal to x plus y plus 3 square v square. So here we solve this and we get dv upon dx equal to 1 plus v square. So now separating the variables and we get dv upon 1 plus v square equal to dx. This is the variable separable form. So here function of v into dv and function of x into dx. So this is the separating the variables form. Now after getting the variable separable form, we integrate both sides and we get integration dv upon 1 plus v square equal to integration dx plus c. So after solving this, this is the dv upon 1 plus v square tan inverse v and dx x plus c. So putting the value of v x plus y plus 3. So here if we take inverse this side, so x plus y plus 3 equal to tan x plus c. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. These are the some unsolved problem for practice. Now we discuss homogeneous differential equation. So whenever we find a differential equation, so first we apply the variable separable form. And if any equation is not solvable variable separable form, second one we reduce the variable separable form. But if any equation is not solvable from variable separable form, or we cannot change it in the reduced to variable separable form, then we put the given differential equation is that form dy upon dx equal to function of xy upon gxy. And if here fxy and gxy both are the homogeneous function of x and y of the same degree is known as homogeneous differential equation. If any differential equation is that form, it's called the homogeneous form. So what is the solution procedure for solving a differential equation in homogeneous form? So first step, suppose this type of differential equation is that form dy upon dx equal to fy upon x. So first step, we put y equal to vx. When we put y equal to vx, if the given differential equation is that type of form and given differential equation is homogeneous differential equation. So first we check the given differential equation is in homogeneous form or not. If the given differential equation is in homogeneous form, so we put y equal to vx. And if we put y equal to vx and we differentiate this, dy upon dx equal to v, differentiation of x 1 to v plus x into dv upon dx. And putting y equal to vx and dy upon dx equal to v plus x dv upon dx in equation number 1. So from 1 we get v plus x dv upon dx equal to fv. So here x dv upon dx equal to fv minus v. So now we get this form. So first we separating the variables. So separating the variables, dv upon fv minus v equal to dx upon x. So this is the variable separable form. And after getting the variable separable form, we integrate both sides. And after getting the integration dv upon fv minus v equal to integration dx upon x plus c. And after solving this integration, we get the required solution of the given differential equation. So let's have a problem. Suppose the given differential equation, solve this, x into sine y upon x dy equal to y into sine y upon x minus x into dx. So first, we get any differential equation, first we apply, can we separate the variables? No, because in sine y upon x, so we cannot. Second one, we check, can we reduce to variable separable form? If not, then we have an expression dy upon dx. So when we put the given differential equation form in that dy upon dx equal to y into sine y upon x minus x upon x into sine y upon x. And when we get in this form dy upon dx equal to something, so this is the homogeneous differential equation. So if the given differential equation is form is in homogeneous differential equation form, so we put y equal to vx. So y equal to vx, and after differentiation this, dy upon dx equal to v plus x dv upon dx. And putting the value of y and dy upon dx in equation 1, and we get, in place of dy upon dx, we put x plus x dv upon dx. And y vx sine y upon x, y equal to vx, cancel, x cancel. So vx into sine v minus x upon x sine v. Or simplify that, v plus x dv upon dx, cancel the v, x, so v sine v minus 1 upon sine v. And after simplification, we get x dv upon dx equal to minus 1 upon sin t. So now, getting this form, now we try to separating the variables. So when we try to separating the variables, we get sin v dv equal to minus dx upon x. So this is the variable separable form of the given differential equation. And after getting the variable separable form, we integrate this term. So integrating both sides, we get integration sin v dv equal to minus dx upon x plus log c. So here log c is the arbitrary constant. We choose according to questions. We take c, log c, tan c, any one. So sin v dv, integration of sin v dv minus cos v, and minus dx upon x, integration minus dx upon x minus log x. So we take, combine this, so minus cos v equal to y upon x, because we have y equal to vx. So y equal to vx when we put, so this is minus cos v. So minus cos y upon x equal to minus log x plus log c. So we combine log c into log x. So we have minus log x plus log c equal to log c by x. So this is the expression c upon x, this c upon x equal to e to power. So when we remove log, so e to power minus cos y upon x. And we can write c also c equal to x e to power minus cos y upon x. This is the simplification. So first we integrate this and getting this expression. And in this expression we choose any arbitrary constant and we put the value of v y upon x. So this is the simplification form. We can choose any one of them. So next, this is some unsolved problem for practice. Now, if the given differential equation form is not in homogeneous differential equation form, so what we can do? We try to reduce the given differential equation in, reduce to homogeneous differential equation form. So suppose such type of differential equation can be reduced to homogeneous form. So first case, what is the first case? If the coefficient of a1x plus b1y plus c and second one a2x plus b2y plus c2. So if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, so then we put the given differential equation, first we put small x equal to capital X plus h and small y equal to capital Y plus k. And if the given differential equation, if we check a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 in the differential equation, so then we put a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 equal to lambda. So we can convert into reduced to variable separable. So let's have a problem. Call dy upon dx equal to y minus x plus 1 upon y plus x plus 5. So here we check the a1 upon a2 is not b1 upon b2. So we put small x equal to capital X plus h and small y equal to capital Y plus k. So therefore, if we differentiate this, dy upon dx equal to d capital Y upon d capital X. So from equation number 1, we put this value. So d capital Y upon dx equal to, when we put small x equal to capital X plus h and small y equal to capital Y plus k, and small dy upon small dx equal to small d capital Y upon d capital X. We put the value and we have this expression. And after getting this expression, now we choose h and k, we choose them so such that in the uppercase minus h plus k plus 1 equal to 0 and h plus k plus 5 equal to 0. If these expression is 0 and after getting solving, we have h equal to minus 2 and k equal to minus 3. And if this expression is 0, so this is the homogeneous differential equation in capital X and capital Y. So we choose here h and k such type ki minus h plus k plus 1 equal to 0 and h plus k plus 5 equal to 0. So after solving these equations, we find the value of h and k, and this is the homogeneous differential equation in capital X and capital Y. So we put capital Y equal to small v into capital X, and after differentiating this, d capital Y upon d capital X equal to v plus capital X into dv upon d capital X in equation number 3. So this is a homogeneous differential equation, so we put y equal to capital Y equal to v into capital X. So we put the value of this and we get this equation. And after simplification, we get this equation. So here, and after simplifying this expression, we get x capital X dv upon d capital X equal to minus 1 plus v square upon 1 plus v. So this is the final expression, and we have here we have separating the variables. And after separating the variables, we have 1 plus v upon 1 plus v square into dv equal to minus d capital X upon x. So here we separating the variables. Now, after separating the variables, we integrate both sides and we get an expression 2 into integration 1 plus v upon 1 plus v square into dv equal to minus 2 into integration dx upon x plus c. So here c is arbitrary constant, and putting the value v capital Y upon capital X, and again we put the value of capital Y. Capital Y is small y minus k, and capital X is small. Here we getting the value of h and k. So here small x equal to capital X plus h, and small y equal to capital Y plus k. So we putting the value of capital X and capital Y in this expression, and we get this is the required solution. These are some unsolved problems. These are some references. Thank you.